Namaskaram. I welcome you all for this evening's presentation on Tiruvarur Sthalam as interpreted in Srimati Rukmini Devi's choreography. It gives a sense of belonging when I present this work of Tiruvarur in a city which is found in the banks of River Muchukunda, also known as Musi.
Just turn it a little bit.
The entire work is based on chauka varnam in ragam todi, talam adi. The composer of this composition, according to Sankita Sampradaya Pradarshini, a huge corpus of musical compendium, it says the composer of this composition is Muthuswami Dikshitar, while Asundaramaya's publication would say this is a composition of Muthuswami Dikshitar's father, Ramaswami Dikshitar. Well, if we go and do a land survey, a field survey in Tiruvarur circles, the Dasis of them, the Nattunars Parampara, including the renowned scholar Dr. B.M. Sundaram would say, this is a composition of Kandasamy Nattuvanar. Well, the work what you're going to see today, it is based on the Sthala Puranam of Tiruvarur, obviously. The kind of study which is made on the Somaskanda Murthy and its symbolism. Interestingly, the little tales and stories revolving around Tiruvarur vis-a-vis Tyagarajaswami. Well, the entire lecture would be on Sri Tyagarajaswami and Tiruvarur. Sri Tyagarajaswami is not the music composer here. It's the Shiva of Tiruvarur Sthalam. Because this young boy was born in Tiruvarur, he was named after this Vaishnava, Kakarla family's Brahmin, Telugu-speaking family's boy was born in Tiruvarur. He was named after the Shiva of the land as Tyagaraja. Henceforth, the composer gets his name from the Lord. So, it's not the other way around. Well, having said that, it also revolves around the praise poems written on the Lord, the philosophical texts which deal with Tyagaraja Swami, the esoteric society, and more than anything, the people, even today, who treat him as a living entity. Before going into the work of it, going to the demonstration, it's so imperative that we understand about Tiruvarur Sthalam as well as Sri Tyagaraja Swami. Tiruvarur. It is a very important Shaivite Sthalam. Yes, of course, when it comes to Shaivite history in South India, especially in Tamil Nadu, you can't avoid Tiruvarur. Tiruvarur is not a geographical location to many of the people. Though map says there is a point called Tiruvarur, we will discuss what it is so. If you are speaking about the political history of Tamil Nadu, one cannot avoid Tiruvarur because Chola history more or less revolves around major part of Tiruvarur, yes. Also around Kumbakonam, certainly around Tanjavur, but Tanjavur Jilla, but Tiruvarur cannot be avoided. Even we are speaking about the religious history of Tamil Nadu, the Shaiva history essentially revolves around Chidambaram, certainly, and also Tiruvarur, majorly. The main deity of the temple is Sri Valmikanatha, also in Tamil also called as Putridam Kondar. Well, there is a negotiation between the audience and the speaker here that it will be a grave mistake if we cannot quote Telugu and speak about Venkateswara Swami. Telugu goes as the bedrock. Vis-a-vis, we can't take away Tamil and speak about Tyagaraja Swami of Tiruvarur. Henceforth, the entire lecture will be dotted with many anecdotes and whatever terms and poems from the copious literature of Tamil. Well, Putridam Kondar is the main deity. As I said, Tiruvarur's temple, there's a famous adage called, it goes, Koil Aindhu Veliyam, Teertha Kulam Aindhu Veliyam, Sengalunir Odai Aindhu Veliyam, which means the surface area of the temple is equal to the surface area of the water pond, is equal to the surface area of the lily pond, what the flowers are grown, roughly equal to 25 acres. A solid temple of 25 acres, a solid water tank of 25 acres, a vision, a treat to watch. Many Kshetram, when we speak about it, generally we discuss three parts: Kshetram, Tirtham, and Murtham. Kshetra, the place, the Mahatmyam of the Kshetra, the Tirtha Mahatmyam, and the Murtha Mahatmyam. Tirtha is the water pond, the greatness of the water pond, and the icon. One of them will be great in given Stala, but very few places has all the three to be importantly praised. Tiruvarur is one such. The Kshetra, the Tirtha, and the Murtha are important. Having said that, the hero of this tale, Valmikanatha, is the anthill there. You see an anthill on top, right side corner. And then, his wife is a lotus. The anthill is married to a lotus. He has another wife, perhaps the embodiment of the lotus. This is in the morning and the evening, the lily. At times, he is hidden within the serpent hole there. There's a hole you see, it's a Nagabira. He's hidden, he's worshipped there. The fertile lands are worshipped, all as the embodiment of Shiva. We come to know it would have been an agro-pastoral community we are speaking about, who have been worshipping all these things, but finally they would conclude it into something called the worship of Sri Tyagaraja Swami. It has kind of metamorphosed into worship of Tyagaraja Swami. The main anthill there is Valmikanatha, and his wife is called as Soma Kulambal. In Tamil, she is also called as Padi Tanda Pattini. One who does not cross her home, the Garbhagudi, she has never crossed. She is a Padithanda Patini. The processional deity of Tiruvarur is our hero, Sri Tyagaraja Swami. Actually, many of us, when we think of Chidambaram, immediately we relate to Nataraja. Not many of us know Nataraja is only a processional deity of Chidambaram. The main Shivalinga is Adimulanatha. His wife is Umaya Parvati. The processional deity in Chidambaram is Sri Nataraja, and his consort is Shivakama Sundari. Likewise, in Tiruvarur, the processional deity is Sri Tyagaraja Swami, and his consort is called as Katyayani Devi, Kondi Amman, also called as Neeloth Palambal, the lotus, the blue lotus. The blue lotus. Well, having said this, there are something important, that the place where the Valmika, the main anthill, is housed, it's called Tirumulattanam. Imagine, since it is an anthill, the entire Tiruvarur is considered to be the body, extended body of Shiva. Yesteryears, no one were allowed to wear shoes within the premise of Tiruvarur because there is an extended body of Valmikanatha. The processional deity, as I told, he is housed in a place called Pungoil, or Poo, flower, the flower temple. In Shaivite parlance, when you say Koil, it means Chidambaram. In Vaishnava parlance, when you say Koil, it means Srirangam. But in Shaiva parlance, when you say I'm going to Periya Koil, or the big temple, it is not the big temple of Tanjavur, it means Tiruvarur. Big temple, no, Tanjavur, big temple is all today's nomenclature. If you talk to a Shaivite and you say, I'm going to a big temple, it means you're visiting Tiruvarur. Actually, the tank here is one of a wonder to watch. It's supposed to be a confluence of 501 Tirthas. This is written in Kamalalaya Sirappu, a text. The Kamalalaya is a confluence of 64 Tirthas. That's a separate confluence of 64. The goddess, the main goddess of Tyagaraja Swami, as I told, is Sri Kamalambal. She is a Bhattarika, she is a queen. She is one goddess who sits in Kuttikasana. We'll describe about her. The Sala Vriksha is Sivappu Padari. This Kshetra has so many names to it. Muladhara Kshetram, Prithvi Kshetram, Pakshi Kshetram, Nitya Pradosha Kshetram, Sarvadosha Nivarti Kshetram, Antaru Gateshupuram, Hatakeshupuram, Muchukundapuram, Valmikapuram, Devashrayapuram, Deva Yagapuram, Skandapuram, Shripuram, Purushapuram, Punyapuram, Kalisela Nagaram, Kamalapuram, Panchalinga Kshetram. Many, many, many more. At least 300 names are there. Muladhara Kshetram. Shaivites, it's a very, I think India, we all, most of us know we are familiar with the Paribhasha. It's a technical term within that particular school of system of work. There is a coherence there. When you say Muladhara, it refers to Tiruvarur. Converse is also true. When someone says I visited Tiruvarur, you are still meditating on the Muladhara. Someone would say I visited Swadhisthana, or Tiruvanikavil, it means a Swadhisthana. The Manipuraka is Tiruvannamalai. Anahata is Sri Kalahasti, Vishuddhi is Chidambaram, Agnya, Kashi, Sri Kedaram, Sahasrara, Kedarnath, Sahasrara. 12 inches above that, Sri Kailasha. That is supposed to be the silver temple. 12 times the size of the body you multiply, it is the golden temple. That's the golden Kailasha. Tangamalai, it's in Tamil, there's a very interesting term called Tangamalai Rahasyam. Golden mountain secret. 12 times of your measure, that measure is called Paramashiva. We'll deal with this. Is called the Muladhara Kshetra because you meditate on the Muladhara. Prithvi Kshetra, because the entire extended body of Valmikanada is there, this becomes the Prithvi Kshetram. Most of us are familiar with Panchabhuta Kshetram. There is not only one set of Panchabhuta Kshetra. There are many, many circles of Panchabhuta Kshetras. Gudimallam is also one, which is in Andhra. But people are generally familiar with the Choladesas. Whatever we say, the five is the popular Panchalinga Kritis or Panchabhuta Kritis are written in the Choladesas, not in the Tondai Mandala, not in the Pandit Desa, not in the Chera Desa. Tiruvarur is the Prithvi Kshetram in the STRs, important Prithvi Kshetram. Pakshi Kshetram. Pakshi here means, it's not a word as such, it means one cycle of Shwas, Nishwas and Ushwas. Inhale and exhale, it's called one Pakshi. The entire bedrock of this is something to do with breath, human breath. It's a Pakshi Kshetra. Shiva is here, it's called Om Sri Pakshi Rajaya Namaha. Pakshi Raja, one who is a Raja of the breath, Pakshi. It has two wings. The piss Pakshi has two wings, the inhale and the exhale being two wings. If you break one wing, it can't survive. Nitya Pradosha Kshetram. Pradosha is generally in a given month, twice it happens. Nitya, daily Pradosha is celebrated in this temple and every evening he dances. Pradosha Natanam. And that Natanam is called Ajapa Natanam. Sarva Dosha Nivarti Kshetram. All the doshas are gone. Antaru Gateshupuram, it travels within one's body. You can travel within. That is called as Tiruvarur. It's not a visiting a place. Hatakeshupuram. Hatakam means a kind of a gold. Visiting that serpent Nagabilam there, that the hole within it, that's called the Hatakam. Hataka gold, Nagabilam. So that's a Shiva Linga. If you go there, there'll be no linga there, there'll be a hole there. That is called Hatakeshupuram there. Muchukundapuram. A king Muchukunda worshipped Shiva there. Valmikapuram, as we say, it's counted of Valmik. Devashrayapuram, devas come and stay there. Devayagapuram, devas did the yagnyam there. Skandapuram, the entire rituals of Tiruvarur is based on Muruga in one way you look at it. Shripuram, Lakshmi does tapas even today there. In the sense, when you go to the entire temple, the pivotal center of the temple is not the Garbhagudi. It's one small shrine dedicated to Sri Lakshmi. She is doing eternal tapas there. You can't see a person who's doing tapas in general tradition that you can't visit him face to face. There will be a window. Generally a window, you can only take a side entrances for them. Even in the Lakshmi Kshetram side, you can enter through. It is called the Shripuram. Purushapuram, because he is a Shri Purusha. Shiva himself is called the Shri Purusha. Punyapuram, because of the Punyam what the Stala gives to you. Kali Sela Nagaram. Shani cannot enter in this place. Navagrahas cannot enter this place. Yama has no job in this place and henceforth he begs to Shiva, give me some job. Let better be the Chandikeshwara of the place. There is two Chandikeshwara in the Kshatram. Adi Chandikeshwara and Yama Chandikeshwara. Pancha Linga Kshatram. Valmikeshwaram, Hatakeshwaram, Ananteshwaram, Achaleshwaram and Siddhishwaram. There are five lingas there on which Dikshitra have sung Panchalinga Kriti of Tiruvarur. In fact, it's very interesting. The two mythical kings are supposed to have ruled here. One is Manunidhi Chola and another is Muchukunda Chakravarti. It's so much of Shaiva fervent here. Suddenly you realize Tiruvarur, the main center, nerve center of Tiruvarur, often in every poet quotes about Manunidhi Chola's existence. What is so great about this Manunidhi Chola's tale? This particular episode is the central house of Madras High Court. If you go to Madras presidency, when it was Madras presidency all across, the High Court, when the Europeans were ruling, they want to kind of create a monument for the justice of this land. If you want to monumentalize as a sculpture, then they chose Manunidhi Chola's episode. The story goes very short, it's a very long story, I'm cutting it short. Most of us, I'll be familiar with the story, yes. The prince goes for a ride and he runs on a calf. The cow goes and rings the bell on the king's fort. King comes out and asks, then he finds that the calf is killed and he once again rides it on his son and kills the son, his own son, as a reply for a justice. Now, it sounds very crude in one way, sounds very crude and very dotted. This is what is the wisdom of the land. They only give you dots. How do you connect? Is the wisdom of the era or the mistake of the era? Yes, you can actually connect and make a mistake. End time, you can just lose the point. This becomes the pivotal center of discussion of Tiruvarur. Like what? How can you even kill your son? What right do you have? Still this debate happens. It's a dharma kshetra. More than anything, it's a debate on justice. It's a dharma kshetram, dharmavati, dharmavan. Justice debates were happening more than anything. And more, it's an interesting, even the tale connects to one place, episode of Sibi Chakravarti. We know the story of it, but the dots are clear, but to connect it. A pigeon takes a refuge, but in order to save it from an eagle, you need not expect anything from the pigeon, but you have to cut your thigh and give, bleed it to death. And the pigeon can fly over, that's fine. But it's a refuge, it's come in search of a refuge. And as a king, you can't expect anything back from a refugee. You can't expect anything back from any refugee who has taken a refuge. A refugee is a person who can be a king in his own land, but the moment he has taken refuge under you, you have no right to ask anything in return. The only thing you would do is dharma paripalana. The entire clan has to fight for its protection. You can't ask anything in return, and you don't have dharma to ask anything in return. And there's no need to know even the name of the person. That is dharma sthapanas like Tiruvarur, Chidambarams, Tirupatis. These are essentially where justice has to be restored in the land, not necessarily worship. Yes, worship is there. Divinity has to be restored in terms of justice. We easily call them as mythical kings. No, they are itihasic characters who still live in our hearts in a different nomenclatures. Chola Maharaja, Rajaraja Chola, first heard the poems of Shaiva Singh. He was worshipping because it's his own land. In Tiruvarur, he was doing his worship, his protocol worship. Suddenly he heard someone singing beautiful poems. He asked him, who sang these things? I said, we perhaps don't know, but someone, they say there are movers who, there are three poets who sang this. They are supposed to be called as Tirunyana Sambandar and Trinavakarasar and Sundaramurti Nayanar. And we don't know what these poems are. That made him set into an entire entourage and find the entire corpus of Shaiva Tevaram in Chidambaram. The story started in Tiruvarur, landed in Chidambaram. The three great poets, as I mentioned, Sundaramurti Nayanar, who's a friend of Shiva, Tirunavakarasar, who kind of is a slave for Shiva, and Tirunyana Sambandar, who's a son for Shiva. All the three people wrote copious poems in the compilation called Tevaram. Compilation is called as Tevaram. It is a great 315 songs are written on the Swami here. Having said that, coming to the Nayanmars who have been taking the center seat in Tiruvarur, Viranmeendar, Naminandi Adigal, Dandi Adigal, these stories are stories after stories. Dandi Adigal, you can't even imagine a man who's blind, tied a rope to the tree, getting onto the tank and desilting the tank at the age of 80. That is Dandi Adigal. Naminandi Adigal had to light a lamp with water of Kamalalayam. Viran Kadasinga Nayanar, Siruthunaya Nayanar. Interestingly, a man called Seraman Peruman, Seraman Perumal is a Nayanmar, Shaivite saint, but his father is a Vaishnava Aalvar. Kulasekar Aalvar. Kulasekar Aalvar's son is Seraman Perumal, who is a very close friend of Sundaramurthy. Sundaramurthy is a friend of Shiva. He thought, I'll call friend's friend, so I'll get in touch with Shiva. That's a protocol what Seraman Perumal used. Interestingly, Somasi Maranayanar is a kind of a, he is a Telugu speaking priest. Somaji, Somayaju, Somayajulu. The name is very prevalent to all of us. Most of them follow Soma Siddhantin protocol. They're all Soma Siddhantins and they are very prevalent in Tiruvarur belt, even now. It's a temple with 501 Ganapatis. There's a street called Ainuthiyor Pillayar temple street. 501 Ganapatis are there. Saraswati, Lakshmi, Parvati got their marriage done there. It's called Kalyanapuram. It has 8 flagpoles, 8 Bhairavas, 8 Durgas, 113 Sannidhis. That is Tiruvarur as a temple. Sri Tyagaraja Swami. Trinamakasra, the poet in Tevaram, in Tiruvarur Tiruthandagam, he says, Oruvanai Ulagai Eta Nindanalo, Or Uruve, Muvuruvum Ananalo, Karuvanai Kalane Munkaindanalo. Is that the day when you appeared as a single whole entity? Or the day when you split yourself into Trinity? Is that the day when you burnt Kama? Or is that the day when you kicked Kala? Maruvanai Mannum Vinnum Terittanalu. Is that the day when you split yourself into the sky and the earth? Maan Marike Yendi, Or Madhu Or Vagan. The day when you hold the deer or the day when you split yourself to have a woman in your left? Thiruvanal Servadarku Munno Pinno. Is it that day? Is it before that occasion or then later? Tiruvarur Koyila Kondanale. Is that the day when you enter the temple of Tiruvarur? That's what the question Navakar sir puts in front of Shiva. We don't know the antiquity of this worship. So, the name of the Lord, yesteryears he was called as Aruran. Not Sri Tyagaraja Swami. Aruran, Vidhi Vidangan. Because the place is filled with Ar, Indian labrum, a kind of a tree. There are two places, Vada Arur and Ten Arur. It's northern and southern. Like we know, there are many Kuchipudis and Peddapudis across in Andhra. There are many, you know, Vada and Ten kind of Mela Kira kind of nomenclatures across Tamil Nadu. This is Vada Arur and Ten Arur. This is called Ten Arur, actually. He's the lord of Ten Arur. It's called as Arur. He's also called as Vitanka, Vidangan. In Sanskrit, Vitanka. Tanka is chisel. Vitanka, no chisel. So, uli tinda meni, that the body that has not been chiseled. The word vi also means a bird. Tanka means residence. Akasha pakshina tankayati iti vitankaha. The place where the akasha pakshi is staying, that is called vitankam. Vis-a-vis, where the space is breathing, is called vitankam. In Tamil, vidangam mani beautiful. Also means beautifier. He is not just beautiful, he beautifies the space around. Is called Vidangan. In Tamil, Vidangu, Vidu Kuttu Tangal, Vidu and Tangal means something which is staying in the crack. There is a crack in the space and something is staying in the crack. If that is an entity like that, and that entity is called as Vidangar. He is also called as, popularly as Sri Tyagaraja Swami. Tyagam in Sanskrit means to abandon, to give up. But in Tamil, Tyagam means charity also. King of charity. In Tamil, generally we say, avar evaradathum tyagam vaanga mattan. He'll never get charity from anyone. Ivar tyagam kodutte palagiyavar. He'll always do charity. Tyagaraja is Tyagaraja. Charity, king of charity. By the way, this man is treated like a mendicant in the morning. You go to Tiruvarur, his nivedanam in the morning is bitter god with little kanji. That's porridge. In the morning he's served. Afternoon he's treated like a man. Normal man. Sadhya daliha. Evening. That is something to enjoy. Someone can open a Tyagaraja restaurant. I know, I'm very serious about it. You go there, people would cook every... I've seen in the visits that I would see, women and the men, they would go and pick up one vada from their house and give it to him. The Taliha evening protocol is very, very interesting. According to the temple protocol, he has to be served with fruit juice. He is given 60, yesteryears he was served with 64 kind of sweets in the evening. And a whole big taliha every single day. Well, he had 365 leelas. It's called Tyagaraja leelas. Each and every single day, one leela was enacted. So 365 days of the year, 365 utsavas. And for this, Nibandhanas was given by Chola kings, Pandya kings. Well, that's a big story. Having said about his name, to know the story of what it is, I'm saying, Shri Tyagaraja, how he landed up here. The small story that Mahavishnu, he was in yearning to have a son. He has already created the Manasika Rupam of the son in his mind. It was carved out of Mat of Mahavishnu. Henceforth, just because he was born from the Matha of his Mana, he is called Manmatha. He is a Manasika Putra, Manoja, born from the Manas of Mahavishnu. He inculcated desire in Mahavishnu, hence he is called as Kama. He burnt Mahavishnu in his desires called Kandarpa, Darpaka, Anangaha, Kamaha, Panchashara, Smara, Sambarari, Manasija, Kushumeshu, Ananyaja. These are all the names and everything associated Mahavishnu. Now he did tapas to Shiva and he said, can I get a son like this, please? He said, granted. But the sister got infuriated. Parvati said, you never worshipped me, so I give a curse on you. Who gave you birth, he will burn him down. He said, what do I do now? He said, I'm very sorry, brother, you have to have it. Now he says, okay, fine, that's fine, you have it, but can there be a prayaschitta done? Yes. There is one place where all the doshas will be clarified. Go to Tiruvarur, do tapasya there. He said, okay, I'll do, but where is this Tiruvarur? That's another big, this answer becomes a big compendium of called Tyagaraja Rahasyam or Tiruvarur Rahasyam. It is not a geographical location she's speaking about at all. Now, she said, you worship, as you have denied me, you worship my husband and me and my child together as a Manasika Rupa in your Manas and keep it in it. Is it fine? I would do that. So, this particular image is called Ambika Guha Samyutaye Namaha. That's, since Muchukunda Chakravarti worshipped, this is part of one of the archanas called Muchukunda Sahasranamam, Sri Ambika Guha Samyutaye Namaha. Vishnu goes, takes it in the Manasika Rupa and he lies in the milky ocean and he dies. And he kind of, in the Yoga Nidra, as the chest is moving up and down, Tyagaraja Swami goes up and down dancing. As the ocean is going side to side, he is also dancing side to side. And so, the very peculiar dance, it's called A Japa Natana. A Japa Natana. A Japam is always said out. A Japa, that which has not been said out, it means the breath. Vishwam, Vishnu, the breadth of the cosmos to which he is dancing. Imagine the breadth of the cosmos of Mahavishnu's body having the manas. Within that manas, there is Tyagaraja Swami and he is dancing to the breath, Ushvasa and Nishvasa, and to the sides and sides of the milky ocean, side and up and down. Om Vishnu Samutpanna Vitanka Atma Swarupavate Namaha, one of the Muchukunda Archanas. Born from Vishnu, Vishnu Samutpanna Vitanka, unchiseled, Atma Swarupavate Namaha. Now, Indra, the entire Deva Asura Yuddha, Valkali attacks Devaloka, incessant war. Now Indra goes and begs for support from Mahavishnu. Mahavishnu gives Tyagaraja Swami to him and says, keep it, have it in Amaraloka, worship it. He worships, the war is gone. After many aeons, another Valasura comes, who is kind of a brother clan to Valkali, and attacks Devaloka. This time, Valasura has taken a boon that he could only be slayed by a human. He has no other choice. Now he had to ask a support from a great king. The king he chose is Muchukunda, son of Mandata Manu. There are many Manus we know. Mandata Manu's son he is. He belongs to the Ikshvaku dynasty, or the Surya, the Solar dynasty. His brother is the celebrated character in Bhagavata, Ambarisha. Purukutsa is also one of the brothers. Now, he goes and helps Indra. This Indra Devasura Yuddha gets settled. And Indra is very happy. He said, whatever you ask, I'll give you, my dear friend. Except three. Don't ask for Kalpaka Vriksham. Don't ask for Kamadeyanu. And don't ask for Indrani. You can take anything else. Suddenly, Tyagaraja Swami felt that he never mentioned him. He goes to the dream of Muchukunda and says, you better ask me. Next day he goes, can I give it to Rajaswami? And saying, Aruran, Vitangan. He gets shocked. He said, except me and Indrani, no one knows there's Vitanka here because he's invisible to everyone. How does he know? Now he says, but that's what I want. If you want to give me this or nothing else. I can go back. I said, no, no, I'll give you. Now he is shamed. He had to do something. He calls Vishwakarma and he asks him to do 6 replicas of, like, so totally 7 are displayed. If you identify the original, you can take it. Now when he goes and keeps on checking, Vinayaka comes to his rescue. Didi Vitanka Vinayaka comes to his rescue and points at him, and this is what it is. He gives a parichanna list. Based on this list, you can identify. He says it as an ashariri voice within his mind. He identifies. Indra is shamed. He said, I don't have the arhata to have all the, including the original and the replicas. Please take all the 7 along with you. He walks down. Fine. Shiva himself says to Muchukunda and says, I don't want to live in Amaraloka. Yennai Tiruvarur kondu sel, poojanai sel. Take me to Tiruvarur and do poojana to me. He descends down, like what? With 18 instruments and the instrument players. Panchamukha Vadyam, primary instrument in Tiruvarur. Bari Nayanam, short version of the Nadaswaram. Berigai, Periyathalam. Pullangudal, Sankhu, Suddhamaddalam, Seyamangalam, Kodugotti. It will be like a small tabla. Karna, Yadakka, Tavandai, Tutti, Tiruchinnam, Nattuvathalam, Yakkalam, Vanga and Veenai. 18 instruments with the instrument players. They descend down from the heaven and all of them are given homes. And all of them are servants of Tyaraja Swami. All the communities come and settle down from the Indra Loka. While Indra is born in Tiruvarur, he says, what do I do, Swami? I've done this to you. He said, don't worry. One day I'll get out and face you east. Then you will get your Shapa Vimochana. Because the Shapa he gives is, you will be born as a Parayan in Tiruvarur. Paraya is of caste. And he says, Yana Yerum Perum Parayan. The Paraya who rides on the top of the elephant. Still there is the community calls themselves Yanayurum Perumparayam Tiruvaru. They live just in the eastern corner of the temple. The community is living. They descend down and he is there. Tyara Swami is descended. But who is to install him? Muchukunda Chakravarti along with Durvasa Rishi. Interestingly, on the Vasantakala, on the Chandrodaya, and the time when the Chandra is meeting Guru, on the Guru Pusam, Guruvaram, in the Kataka Lagnam, he is installed by Durvasa Rishi and Muchukunda Chakravarti. There is a very similarity here. Something happens very similar in Chidambaram also. Taimasam, Guru Pusam, Pagal Neram. There is a very famous compass, Natana Madinar. This phrase comes. Taimasatil, Guru Pusatil, Pagal Neratil. The only difference here is, this is Vasantakalam. There also he dances, but it is Ananda Tandava, Ananda Natanam. Here it is Ajapa Natanam. In the morning he danced, both of them danced. Having descended and dancing there, these 7 people are housed in 7 different villages around. There is a cult in Tiruvarur, it's called as Paryanka Yogam or Shivaraja Yogam, in which Tiruvarur is the Muladhara Chakra. If you say Tiruvarur, it's Muladhara Chakra. Muladhara is Tiruvarur. Next, Tirukkaravayil, Tirunagai Karanam, also called as Nagapattanam, Tirunallaru, Tirukkuvalai, Tiruvayimur, and Tirumaraikkad. These are the 7 places of the Adhara Chakras. Respective Vitankas placed, Vidhi Vidangar, Adi Vidangar, Avani Vidangar, Bhuvani Vidangar, Sundara Vidangar, Naga Vidangar, and Neela Vidangar, the Blue Lotus. Respective dances, Ajapa Natanam, Kukkuta Natanam, Paravara Taranga Natanam, Unmatta Natanam, Hamsapada Natanam, Bringa Natanam, and Kamala Natanam. Kamala, Blue Lotus, Neela Vidangar. This is the ensemble of, these are the pivotal centers when you speak about the political centers of Choda dynasty. Wherever Choda dynasty spread itself, 2 major icons they installed was, one Nataraja, next Tyagaraja. The Somaskanda Murti and the Nataraja Murtis are the icons they generally installed in the entire Choda Desa. This 7 are called Sapta Vitanka Stala, and there is something called Upaya Vitanka Stala, 3, and 13 Prati Vitanka Stalas. Entire Choda Desa is spread across, ruling the roost with Somaskanda Murti and Tyagaraja. Whenever we praise to kings, we sing Dasangam, the 10 Angas of the king. In Tamil, it is called Payar, name, Nadu, country, Oor is capital, Aru, river, Malai, mountain, Puravi, horse, Padai, army, Murasu, Tar is the garland, and Kodi, flag. All of them have to be sung. These are the yesterday when you do Abhinaya, when you do for Swami, all the Dasangam has to be shown for every Swami. Yesterday the tabulation was very clear. For Tyaraja Swami, Payar, Aruran, Nadu, Kamalai Nadu, Oor, Tiruvarur, Aru, Ananda Aru, Malai, Arul Malai, Arul is grace. Puravi, horse, Vedas. Padai, the elephant form is Airavanam. The chariot he had was Aditya, the ocean becoming his own, the ocean of the cosmos becoming his own chariot. His Kalat Padai, that is army, is Viduparamarayar. 64 families are responsible for his army welfare. Actually, it's not 64. He had two swords. He is a Maharaja with two swords. Right side is called Veeravandayam or Veerakadgam. Left is called Jnanakadgam. For this, 64 villages are slaves. For this Kadgam, 30 and odd villages are slaves to it. They are a big, big, big confluence of discussions of servitudes. I don't use the word slave, it's a wrong connotation in current thing. Servitudes, still they have the Nibandhanas to these swords, not to Tyagaraja Swami. They don't get married with each other. There's an entire administration been happening under the name of Tiruvarur's administration. Murasu Panchamukhavadin, there's a peculiar drum with five faces. Bari Nayanam, he has a thing to accompany that. He wears a red lily kind of a garland, and his flag is called Tyaga Sabha. It has the icon of a bull. It's called Tyaga Sabha. Having said this, in this particular composition, Roopamu Joochi, Valachi, Vachitin, it's a beautiful, sweet, solid composition which has been sung by many, many, many composers. Like many people, many great singers have sung this composition. Since, I had to just say, every time when I spoke in many parts of Tamil Nadu, I had a problem explaining these words. I had to explain these words. Here, I think I'm just taking the other way and I'm not going to explain the sahityam here. Roopamu Joochi Valachi Vachitini. Kopamu Chetura. Swami Inta Kopamu Chetura. Tapatraya Harudai Velayu. Sri Tyagaraja Swami Ideni. Very simple Telugu. No complexities. Mara Koti Sundara Kara. This is a composition, very beautifully set to music. We'll hear the todi now. A little strong todi. Yes, but what is this rupam? Actually, this rupam of... He does not have a rupam. That's another thing. Dikshitar gives... What is the rupam? Dikshitar, Mutswami Dikshitar... I think I'm taking a liberty here. Muthuswami Dikshitar, Shama Shastri and Sri Tyagaraja as a composer, all the three were born in Tiruvarur only. But Tyagaraja composer, he had his samadhi in Tiruvayyar. That's another thing. Tiruvayyar is different from Tiruvarur. They are not the same. If you go to temple, go to the other corner and shout, you can hear Tyagaraja's house replying. This side you go and run and shout, Dikshitar's house replying. That corner, Shama Shastri, they are just around the temple. These houses are. So you can see their entire dedication, the lifetime being spent, the families have spent. Dikshitar's composition on Tiruvarur Tyagaraja Swami, many, many compositions are there, many compositions. When you collect how he says the rupam of Sri Tyagaraja Swami, he says Sadashiva Swarupam, Sachidananda Swarupam, Satya Jnana Ananda Swarupam, Purusha Prakriti Swarupam, Prakriti Vikriti Swarupam, Bhoga Yoga Swarupam, Bhukti Mukti Swarupam, Chandra Surya Swarupam, Tattva Maya Swarupam, Prithvi Apa Deyu Vayu Akasha, Nada Bindu Kaladi Swarupam. Chandra Surya Kala Dina Yuga Varsha Swarupam, Vak Artha Swarupam, Shiva Shaktyadi Shakala Tattva Swarupam. At least I have traced 13 epithets what Shiva, Dikshitar has said about the Swarupam of Tyaraga Swami. This is from the composition of Dikshitar only. Since majorly this composition is known as Muthuswami Dikshitar's composition, I had to dwell on that part of it. I never went into the other people's connotation. What is the Roopam of Sri Tyagaraja Swami? And how Srimati Rukmini Devi has envisaged it? I mean, I'm not getting into the details of the composer here. She is who she is, be it anyone, be it X or Y. Let us speak by the work of it. So I'm going to use the word choreographer or the composer here or the artist here, rather than getting onto the names of the person who is more than their name, more than their lives. At times it is so that such works have to be discussed. And praise is fine, they have lived their lives, but we have to speak them through their work more than their anything else. So let us see what the work speaks about. The Varnam, Roopamu Joochi, Valachi Vachitini in Ragam Todi, Talam Adi. Composition heard and performed in the areas of Tiruvarur and Tanjavur belt. Swarupam is a mantra swarupam. Irukkindra mandiram yerayiramam. There are 7,000 mantras. Irukkindra mandiram yettirathillai. What this mantras will not do? Irukkindra mandiram sivan tirumeni. This is supposed to be the menu of Shiva. Irukkindra mandiram ivannam thane. This is what is the internal content of the mantra, says Tirumular in his Tirumantiram. It's a mantra swarupi. Actually, there is a tradition of Sapta Koteshwara. Swachanda Tantra says the body has 3.5 crore pores. When we breathe once or once out, inhale and exhale, 3.5 and 3.5 becomes 7 crore. Sapta Koti Ishwara. Sri Tyagaraja Swami is also called as Sapta Koteshwaraya Namaha. He himself is the breathing content of the universe. Sapta Koti mantras are there. What is the name, the characteristics of it? Ponnana Mandiram, the golden mantra. Ponnana Mandiram, Pugalavum Onnadu. You can't say that through your lips. Ponnana Mandiram, Pori Kinjagattagum. It will mix you. Only the way you can say that is through your breath. Only the breath can speak. Ponnana Mandiram, Pugai Unda Purikil. Pugai Mane, to inhale and exhale. Pugai Unda Purikil. Ponnagum Vallorku Udambu Porpadame. The entire body will glitter like a gold. Oh friends, Tirumurar once again says about the nature of this mantra. The name of the mantra, as we said, is Ajapa Mantra. Japa you say, Ajapa you don't say. Also called as Hamsa Mantra. Hamsa is a conundrum. Soham, Soham. Soham is breathing in and out. Soham, Soham becomes Hamsa, Hamsa. Hamsa Mantra, Breath Mantra. This is something pivotally to do with the Adharas. It is a Panchadashakshari Mantra, 51 Aksharas Mantra. Muladhara has 4 petals, Swadhisthana 6 petals, Manipuraka 10, Anahata 12, Vishuddhi 16. Agnya 2 petals and Sahasrara 1. If you total it, becomes 51. 51 Akshara, this mantra, Panchadashakshari mantra, Hamsa mantra, Ajapa mantra. This particular mantra is supposed to be the Samputa in the chest for the yogis. Shri Vidya Hamsa Samputaya Namaha, O Shri Tyagaraja Swami. Shri Vidya Swarupine Namaha. Shri Pitantar Nivasine Namaha. Tyagaraja Swami's chest is the place where they have kind of codified into a 51 Akshara mantra in a golden plate and kept in the chest. That is his Roopam. When you say the Roopam of Tyagaraja Swami, it's the chest where there's one golden plate. The gold is inside. It's called Ulsad. It's like it's a protecting talisman for a warrior. Outer thing, instead of wearing metals, they wear flowers. It's his armory. Flowers are his armory. Internal, there is an Ulsattu, it's called the Velisattu, the outer covering is the flowers. He is a Raja, Maharaja. Only 2 faces are visible, his and his wife's. The entire body is covered with flowers. You can't see anything else except for the faces. To say the Roopam, the composer has chosen a Hamsasya Hasta to say the Roopam. Because it's a Hamsa mantra, it's a breath. And according to Abhinaya Darpana, the color of Pataka is white, we know, Tripataka is red, so forth. Hamsasya is gold. Color of Hamsasya is gold. And it is drawn horizontally across the chest to see that is the Roopam, because this is the mantra swarupam in the chest. Roopamu Joochi Valachi Vachitini.
Roopamu Joochi Valachi Vachitini.
five faces we know is Panchanana, Sadyojata, Vamadeva, Aghora, Tatpurusha and Ishana. From every face, five other forms came out. So 25 forms are there for Shiva. Ishana Mukam, Somaskanda, Nataraja, Rishabharuda, Chandrasekara, Chandrasekara, Bhikshatana, Kamantaka, Kalantaka, Jalandarari, Tripurari, Gajasamhara, Veerabhadra, Dakshinamurti, Srinilakanta, Kirata, Kankala, Chakradana, Gajantika, Chandeshanugraha, Ekapada, Lingodbhava, Sukhasana, Hariardha, Ardhanari, Umamahesha. 25 forms out of 5 faces, each 5. The first face, Ishana face, the first form which revealed out is Somaskandamurti form. Thinking that you had the maru, the stone axe and the maan in your hand, thinking that I came. But when I came here, I saw something else beyond this 25, says Navakarasar. Ayyayindin appurattanum aarur amarnda ammane. Oh the Lord, who sits beyond this 25 in aarur. But actually we don't know what that form is. Thinking that you are a Somaskanda Murti, we came here, but we see something else there. Worship Tyara Swami, they say his back is 3 times better, beautiful than the front. Munnilum mummadanga pin alaga. The pin is 3 times beautiful than the front. When you go there to worship him, we know it's a separate ornament being made. The back of Tyara Swami is not revealed to everyone. It's a separate ornament. But one thing very sure, if someone is a very sensitive artist, when goes and behind and sees that darshana of the back, I think once, first time when I saw that, it's not an emotional point, but it makes you very emotional. Because you belong to a country where one, we can't say an artist, but a dhyani who can even envisage a back like that. So beautiful. Can't even say how an ornament can be made out of it. But this philosophy of the back is 3 times before the front has nothing to do with the ornament as such, only on the ornament. It has deeper connotations. But Shiva's back is 3 times better than the front. Shiva is hair knot, Jata Makuta, he has Chandra. Chandra is a Krishna Paksha Trayodashi Chandra. Only on the waning side of the 13th day, that Chandra he wears, not every other Chandra. That is the day when great, great saints attain Mukti, Ramana Maharishi, and many people attain Mukti on Krishna Paksha Trayodashi. Ganga, he has Panchaganga on his hair, 5 rivers are running in the forest. Ratnaganga, Devaganga, Kailashaganga, Ugraganga and Brahmaganga. 5 Gangas, 5 waters, henceforth is called Pancha Apa Kesha. 5 water, body, head. He wears Barhi Pincham, Baka Pincham. Like he wears crane feathers as a hunter, as also a peacock feather. He wears 8 flowers, Ashtapushpadara. Bhaga, Drona, Umatta, Sumana, Patala, Padma, Utpala, Gosurya. Ashtapushpadara, he wears as a garland. One of the Nataraja icons would have the 8 flowers there in one of the temples. His hair is so beautiful. The golden and the coppery shiny, that hair I wanted to see. I came all the way, but you're hiding. They would do this particular phrase because I've also had my lessons under P. Ramatilakamma, who is the last Kundi of Tiruvarur. she would, for them, she would say, for this line, those days we used to half an hour for that. Because the Vidvat was like that. Because there's a very important hand in the exposition. Munnala, thrice more beautiful. The next we would go is soul. In Shaiva Siddhanta, we would say the Atman is given with Anava, Karma and Maya. It's born with it. Anava, Karma and Maya. Maya, generally we symbolize with like a timid deer. A timid deer, that's called Mayaman. The deer, very famous motif of the deer, the golden deer of Ramayana. Why? The question goes, why that particular episode to be done not with an eagle, not with a peacock, but why a deer? Deer has a very deeper connotation with Maya. When the Maya is controlled, Jnana is born. Ajapa Gayatri is born. Ajapa Agni is born. The wisdom fire is born from the navel. When the timid man is controlled, could be done only by Sri Tyara Swami himself, then the Jnana Agni is born from the navel and raises to the chest. That's called Ajapa Gayatri. Ajapa Gayatri. In fact, Ajapa Rupena Prana Apana Namaka Chandra Surya Niyamane. This is one of the quotes given by Adi Shankara in defining what Ajapa is. Actually, Ajapa is a goddess. She is Shakti Rupini, worshipped in the Tibetan areas. She is a mountain goddess. Hamsa Rupini, Hamsa. She is also called as Hamsa. Ajapa, Ajapa Devi. Ajapa Rupena Prana Apana. The inhale and the exhale, Namaka Chandra Surya Niyamane. That is, that rides on the Chandranadi and the Suryanadi is called Ajapa. Adishankara gives this from his Lalita Trishati Bhashyam. Ajapa Nama Gayatri Brahma Vishnu Maheshwari. This is from Hamsopanishad. It says, Ajapa Gayatri is more better, all greater than the Gayatris of Brahma, Vishnu and Rudra all put together. In fact, Ajapopa Samhara Iti Abhidiyate. Agni Purana says that that will samharam all the negative energies on the earth. This is from Agni Purana. In fact, Tirumular goes to say, Undi Kamalattu Udithadum Sodhiyai. If you could control the fire which is raising from the navel, Andikkum Mandiram Yaru Marigilar. No one knows the secret or transit point of this fire. Andikkum Mandiram Yaru Marindapin. If someone knows the secret transit, Tandaikkum Unne Magan Pirandani. The son is born before the father. For the timid deer, Maya to be controlled, Ajapa Agni races to watching that I came all the way, my O Lord. Lingodbhava story episode where the Brahma went in search of the head and the Vishnu went in search of the feet. They could not find, and Shiva with his Ishta, when he want to reveal the Rupam. Why this particular story has been chosen is that this is the one of the first time in the mythology when Shiva wanted to reveal his Rupam, he revealed as Lingodbhava Murti with a flare of fire. Linga Udbhava Murti. From the Linga this form was born. Effervescent column of eternally extending column of fire, this Rupam was born as holding with compassion, because when Brahma and Vishnu prayed to him, can you just shorten yourself, minimize and give a visible range of visibility to yourself? He revealed with compassion, he said, okay, I'll do it for you all, don't worry. He came down as a Lingodbhava Murti. Rupamu Joochi Valachi, at least that compassion, can you have it on me? You did it for Brahma and Vishnu, can you do it on me too? Because I can't fathom your Rupam, O Lord. For this, Tirumular once again quotes, Tana Kamalatthi Irunda Chaturmoganum. For the lotus which is seated, man who is seated on top of the lotus, Tana Kamalatthi Aadi Thalaivanum, where one who is sleeping on the black ocean. Oonathin Ulle Uyirpol Olirgindra. Within the pranan, something is shining. Tana Perumburul Tanmayadame. That is a great asset you have. Sounds very cryptic. I know. To put it into linear order itself, it's a little difficult. Nothing, there's a code word he is tracing. Once again, they play with the seven sthanas. The lowest sthana is called Ganapati. The next sthana is called Brahma. Vishnu, Rudra, Maheshwara, Sadashiva, Paranada, Parabindu, Parashakti, then Paramashiva. There's no one spot here. Ganapati, Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, Maheshwara, Sadashiva, Paranada, Parabindu, Parashakti, then Paramashiva. Here, Brahma went in search of high and Vishnu came in search of low as a Varaha. Brahma flew high. Brahma is this part and Vishnu is here. So when these two chakras topsy-turvy to each other, you get into an infinite conundrum. You will never be able to find the Sushumna Nadi. Sushumna is the infinite column of fire. You will never be able to find. It will be going on and on and on, extending out and out and out. This is one of the commentaries you get from Tirumulars. He says, தாரில்லை வேறில்லை பங்கயம் ஒன்றுண்டு பாரில்லை வேறில்லை பங்கயம் ஒன்றுண்டு there is no particular place, there is no root, but there is a lotus somewhere. தாரில்லை வேறில்லை தாமரை பூத்தது there is no root and there is no stem, but how come there is a lotus? ஊரில்லை there is no specific location this lotus grows. காணும் ஒளியது ஒன்றுண்டு but there is an effervescent radiant light somewhere, a blue light. கீழில்லை மேலில்லை கேள்வியில் பூவில் this does not grow on the earth, it does not grow on the akasha, but in between it grows this flower. That flower, that infinite column of fire, I come in search of. Can you please condense yourself and reveal your beautiful form to me, Rupam, to me, O Lord. Can be controlled from other factors to us, like all our worries and everything, on a very mundane explanation. Adi Daivikam, you don't have a control. Adi Bhautikam, totally no control. Like something to do with natural calamities. But the yogic cult of India does not believe this. He said all the three can be controlled. It's okay, that's another discussion. But for some, how do you control it? To do that, the Mantra Swarupi came down and wishfully came to a Swarupa. Nitya, Nitya Ananda, Anati, Malamukta, Swatantra, Sarvajna, Sarvavyapta, Sarvakarta, Shiva. Nitya, who has no form, Nirguna, Nirguna Parabrahma. He wishfully, because of compassion, let everyone get mukti. He chose certain places to manifest. Tiruvarur is one place. To do what? To vanquish the Tapa, Tapatraya Harudai. Velayu, he came, he manifested. So what is the motive of manifestation? In Tiruvaru, there is one sannidhi for Rina Vimochana. Rina Vimochana is one who vanquishes the Rina, Kadan, or the debts. Nothing to do with wealth. In Indian thought, essentially all of us are Rinis. All of us are debtors. You are born with a debt. You do... Indic thought says, you do a vritti, a kolu, a profession to wash off the debts, not to earn money. Money is the last of the facilities you do. Because despite of your income or not, you have to clear your debt in this birth. When a student is coming in search of an education, a teacher can't say, just because you don't have money, you can't get your education. In those were the societies, yesterday's Dharmashastra would quote that education, health and justice are not to be paid. The student cannot pay for the teacher. You should not pay money for this thing. because these three major professionals would do the service to the thing and wash off their debts. You pay or you don't pay, that's not the point. There are people, there have been centuries when people were not allowed to do their profession. Still, they never changed their profession. Especially a society like Vishwakarma tradition, which had constantly been hit by the invasions of the foreign invaders. We know for 200, 150 years, they were not allowed to build temples. But suddenly, after a wave, with two generations of not building temple, how did the third generation build the temple? Because it is not to earn anything. If there is a need, you have to go and serve. And that is your rina. Rina vimochana. You clean your tapam by doing your profession. For that, all the professions of Tiruvarur Jilla, they start a profession, they start in front of rina vimochana sannidhi. Still there is a practice. Rina vimochana is a very interesting Shivalinga installation where the 60th feet, there is a golden plate. 40th feet, the second golden plate. And 20th feet, there is another golden plate. Each to wash off one tapam. Tapatrayam, out of one, Adhyatmikam, Adhidaivikam, Adhibhautikam. Tapatraya Harudai. Then, the entire Kamalalayam, 25 acres water pond, that's the Tirtha. This is called Tapa Harini, also called as Ganga Hrita Tirtham. By taking a dip in it, your tapam is washed. Tapatraya Harudai Velayu Shri Tyagaraja Swami. Tapatraya Harudai. Of my previous birth also. Oh Lord, please wash this off from me. Next hand. Descends from Dyu or the Paraloka. Dyu Loka also called as Paraloka. From there it settled down to Parjanya, the range of clouds. From Parjanya it falls as rain to Prithvi. From there Purusha, then Stri Garbha. Bala, Yavana, Vriddha, Marana. Dyu, Parjanya, Prithvi, Purusha, Stri Garbha, Bala, Kaumara, Vriddha, Marana. This cycle, this is a documented hand in certain older vocabularies of Hastas. This five stages are called Pancha Mahis, Mahitalas. There are five Mahitalas, Pancha Mahis. Wash off all the tapas of this cycle, O Lord. Attachments I have for the soil. They say there are three passions, no? For the earth, for gold, and for the lust. Please wash off all the three, for the earth, and for the gold, and also for all the mayas. Please wash it off, O Lord.
Oh.
part of the Anupallavi, Sri Tyagaraja Swami Idemi. Actually, the hands chosen are very little deeper. Tyagaraja Swami does, the entire, as it mentioned, his entire body is covered with flowers. Annually, twice he reveals his feet, Padadarshana, Panguni Uttara and Dhanurmasa, Margadi Tiruvadri, Arudra, Margadi Arudra. On Panguni Uttara day, he reveals his left leg. On Margadi Tiruvadri day, he reveals his right leg. On the same time, on the same day, Nataraja comes for a Urvala. On the day, he reveals his one leg. And next, on Margadi Tiruvadri other leg, and Nataraja comes for a procession on the day of Arudra Darshanam. This is a leela, once an answer for a leela he did for two devotees. So let us see Tyagaraja Swami Idemi. Chidambaram, for some reasons, for certain difficult times, was kind of transported from there and kept in the Sabhapati Mandapam of Tiruvarur for a while. And still that mandapam is called Sabhapati Mandapam, and the inscription is there in the Thousand Pillared Hall of Chidambaram that he was given that accommodation. He took hiatus and went and accommodated himself in Tiruvarur and came back. Inscription is there in the Thousand Pillared Hall in Chidambaram. The next hand we would do is a very interesting hand, a subtle hand, that Sri Tyagaraja Swami, as I told you, he can't come, whenever he wants to come out, he's a Maharaja, whenever he wants to come out, he can't come exactly in the Eastern Gopura. He has to go to the side entrance called the Vittavasal or the Tittivasal, small entrance. Because Indra is just waiting there in the East, when he gets out, he'll get the Shapa Vimochana. So he can't do that, he'll go to the sides. That's one story, that's one of the Tyagaraja Leela. He's a Maharaja. When Maharajas come out, he does not come out during sunlight. Only in the evenings. Only when there's a moon, he comes out. When people have decided that he's going to come out, in Tiruvarur, people exactly know on how many steps he's going to turn. Because this measure of the place is constant, and they've been witnessing this for ages, and exactly know when Maharaja is out. He is decorated, he is hidden within a cover, within a red cloth and also a red parda, and there will be a black parda. Black is Ajnana, red is Jnana. Crossing Jnanam and Ajnanam, the lion of wisdom will come out. The Maharaja will come out like a lion. Tyagaraja Swami will roar like a lion and come, and everyone would shout, Arura, Tyagesa, Arura. That will be the roar of the lion. As when he comes out, the people, everyone will be alert. All his people who are playing the instruments will be on dot because the Maharaja is out. Interestingly, when he comes out on his walk, as I told you, the sunlight should not touch his body. They would cover right side and left side all on the top with mul cloth, cotton cloth dipped in turmeric because he should not be infected. On top, he would be given with perfumed roots pandal. The pandal will be with perfumed roots. And when he walks, the people would throw the rose water, the paneer, on the roots. It will go and drizzle on face. You can't throw it on the face of the Maharaja. And it is said, Adikku ayiram ponnalikkum ratna simhasanapadi. For every feet, he would throw 1,000 shellings of gold. Today, we throw gems and chocolate, that's different. But once upon a time, he was throwing 1,000 gold varahans of thing when he walked. When he dances, we'll see a speck of a video. He'll be flying like a bird, Hamsa Pakshi. If we speak about his Utsava, it's another thing, like what all happens within him when he comes out of Utsava. But when he comes out in the Rishabha Vahana, he had to come in the sides. The Rishabha there is not Nandikeshwara, it's Vishnu, Mahavishnu himself. It's called Malvide. White Vishnu made of silver, at least as tall as me. The size of that thing. the Vahanam, Mahavishnu's form, as white, fair, made of silver. Before that, an interesting episode happens, that in the morning, till during the Utsava time, Indra is waiting to get Shapa Vimochan. That's a Brahmotsavan time. So in order to pacify him, the protocol says that Tyara Swami, because he doesn't come out in the morning, but generally in Tamil Nadu, the marriage happens in the mornings. So he had to give his power of attorney to another Shiva called Chandrasekhara Swami. It's another Shiva. And his wife Tarunendu Shekari. Both of them go along with Chandikeshwara, go out in the Vittavasal, go to the four-pillared mantapa. There they perform. Indra is waiting there with his wife. He'll say, don't worry, we'll get you married. Every single year, that particular community's headmen and the headwoman, they call the Yanayarum Perumparayan, you know, with the parivatta cloth. They give him the parivatta cloth out of the temple. They get them married again and again, again and again, again and again, till they... It's a marriage... It's a very interesting dependent relationship from one community to the other. To give them respect, they do this. The big communities do to the dependent communities. After this evening, this particular Utsavam, Rishabhavahanam, happens. When the Rishabhavahanam is without a load, the head is like this. When the bull is carrying a load, naturally the horn would go in the front. And the Swami, these were nuances given to me by Ramatilakamma. I'm saying the Tiruvarur Kondi. You said, when you're lifting the Swami, how can you do this? Dancers have a tendency to tip the shikara like that. No. My Swami is a Ganapati, he's a Ganavan. Lift him in Garbhagraham with the respect. Take him carefully and mount him till that the Nandi is allowed to be straight, and then it bends. Little it bends, and the Vahanam is kept on top of it. He becomes a Nandikeshwara. The word Nandi does not mean bull. You have Nandikosha, who is a Buddhist monk. Nandi does not mean bull. Nandi means one who preserves or carries something within himself. One is holding something highly secretive. That's called a Nandi. Nandi Ghosha. Very interesting terminology. When the secret speaks, Nandi Ghosha. That's another thing. But to do that, the composer would have made a very sweet... She would go on the side, take that Nandi, lift it, and when it comes to the end, and come out and come to the Nalukal Mandapam, the center Mandapam, then say, what a play is this, oh Swami. Like master strokes, yeah, they are masters. These masters, they can condense 1,000-word material into 5 words. Only masters can do that. Minimalism, if you break a bit of it, it is broken. It's like the master strokes of a child's painting. By 2 strokes, there is a mountain. If you break 1 stroke, there is no mountain. Only to a child's eye, the entire mountain is filled. Animals are there, rivers are there, monkeys are jumping. Their eyes can see that, but only our eyes can't see that. These are like, how dare, we can't even reduce 1 stroke from Picasso. You reduce 1 stroke, the entire painting goes for a crash. These hands are like that. The composer, it's like minimalistic, reduce. And it's not a conscious reduction. It's by the grammar it is reduced. It's not, oh, I have to do a very, very minimalistic hand. No. When you're very clear about centering, you only use 1 word to do many things. Because they say, no, power does not shout. It only makes a statement. The power of wisdom will never shout. It only makes a statement. The statement is clear, crystal clear, etched. You can't move yaha maha, yaha pe yaha. It is clear. Minimalistic strokes. but you can see an ocean within it. You can dump, fill an ocean, and these simplified versions of great hastas, a deva hasta, is given to such dancing, performing artists and say, please do not get into the details of it, but please dance the way it is. Imagine the kind of wisdom which can create an entire truth into two hastas. Shivalinga has been come to this. You can't reduce it furthermore. And to reach this, they would have had hundreds of years of discussion. It's not one, it's not... That's why they say don't change these things. It's not anything to do with creativity. See, you can... One thing interesting is, when you do a Shivalinga like this, it is not the shape. It is not the shape of the Shivalinga that matters. It is the linga-ness that matters. If there's a content of the linga that has been condensed into an essence like this. It is not the shape of the Shivalinga. Shape is one of the most visual part. What will happen to a blind devotee who's searching in Shivalinga? Even for him, this is Shivalinga. It has nothing to do with the shape outside. Because not many people are familiar with unfamiliar shapes of Shivalingas. There are certain Shivalingas as tall as this tree. Only the central part. Base is very small. There are Shivalingas, sorry to use a metaphor, it's like an idli. But they are Shivalingas. If you go to the beds of Tungabhadra River, under the river, if you go to Hampi, everywhere on the rock beds, you have small, only this much, like a cake. Yes. Actually, the point is, it is not, Shivalinga is not about the shape. Not even Shivalinga. Any icon in India is not about the shape. It's entirely about the content. That does not mean Indian iconographists never knew realism. That does not mean they can. First of all, when you see an icon there, it has nothing to do with human body. Because a normal human body is 8 times the face. For perfect is 8.5. Fine. What do you do with Nataraja? He's 10 times the face. To hide that, he's bending one leg, he's lifting another leg, he's bending his torso. These are the work of the Vishwakarma tradition. I give you an idea. How do I put it? Because when Nataraja stretches, he's 10 times his face. Kalasamhara Murti is 12 times his face. They are minimalistic reduction of the ideas. They have nothing to do with realism. That does not mean they don't know to do realistic work. That's a balapatam. It's very, very young. Yes, in their tradition, especially in Indian Indic tradition of art, you don't see what you see. You work what you cognize. Ulladai ulladu pol allamal, ulladai unarvadu pol. It's not what I see I do as a work of art. It's what I cognize I do as a work of art. So to draw one lotus, I observe millions of lotuses. And I draw the lotus-ness, not the lotus. Why I do draw lotus-ness? If I don't know the lotus-ness, if I can't capture it, I would never be able to make a Kamal Mahal. A Kamal Mahal, you go and search for a lotus petal, nowhere you'll find a lotus petal there. Lotus-ness is captured in it. This tank is called Kamal Alayam. You don't find lotus buds there. What is the idea behind the lotus-ness behind the water? These are minimalistic yet very, very stringent questions of Indian contribution or Indic. I don't want to say Indian. Indic as a bigger Eastern thought, if you want to say. In fact, it is so interesting that the word lotus itself, Kamala Alayam, Kamala, that which has a capacity to hold something within itself, that which has a capacity to expand itself, that which has a capacity to cringe itself is called a lotus. It's called a Kamala. Just because that particular flower also goes by the standard, that flower is also called as a Kamala. Eyes are called Kamala. That's why face is called Kamala. That's why the hands are called Kamala, Hasta Kamala, Pada Kamala. It's not because of the lotus shape. It's because of these qualities, the Lakshanas. These three qualities, that is imbibed. I know we say Lakshmi as Kamala. Sri Lakshmi is also called as Kamala. Goddess is Kamala. This reductionism in Indianness, in Indian art, is very, very intense. It's very dense. It's like this. These are grammars. They are not, in a way, they are not memorized poetries. You need not memorize a poetry. You just learn a grammar, we create poetries. Indian art is about learning grammar. Age-old grammars. Age-old grammars are transferred. It's a grammar actually. It is given to a child to fill the poetry throughout the life. As a dance I give you, these hastas, as a devahasta, rishi hasta, whatever I give you, please have it and fill whatever color you want throughout your life. It would take another, maybe a person like me, I took 9 to 10 years to fill it. A person like her, she took 15 years to do this. She has been doing this varnam for past 15 years or not. And still, you keep filling these data points. These are pivotal grammar points, and you keep filling and expanding and expanding and expanding. This is specifically very Indic in thinking. The next hand is a very interesting hand, very condensed hand. Sri Tyara Swami wears two serpents, Vasuki and Ananta. Vasuki has right and head. You see a picture there, Sri Tyara Swami, with two of the ear lobes. That's called Sevandi Todu. With Jevandi flowers, he makes two ear lobes as ear ornaments. And there are two malas. In Tiruvarur tradition, they don't tie the garland in the end. It's like the shape of a serpent. You have to, it's called, even now you go, we pay 500 rupees, we can hire that. It's called Pani Set. Pani Set Archanet is called ticket. Pani, the word means serpent, a Sanskrit Pani. Vasuki and Ananta with the Sevandi Todu they give you. It is said they are the two Idab and the Pingala Sushumna Nadis. The Nadi has to go, grow above, cross 12 inches above the head and descend back into the body. Then he becomes a Shivaraja Yogi. This is called Brahmandaram. The 12th inch is called Brahmandara. There it has to cross. The Ida and the Pingala Nadi with the Sushumna crosses, descends back as a Amrita Varshini. The word Amrita Varshini refers to this. Raga Amrita Varshini's coinage comes from here. Amrita Varsha descends back. And then Sri Tyara Swami walked with the serpent garland in the earth of Tiruvarur. It's a very interesting a story around this particular delineation, that his friend Sundaramurthy Nayanar is a great friend, the devotee of him. This friend had the liberty to call the Swami. The first poem he writes on Shiva, the first title he gives to him is Madman. Pitta, Piraisudi, Perumani, Arulala. That's the first poem he writes, Sundaramurthy Nayanar. In the entire poems, you see, every time he fights with Shiva, like, you know, you're not my friend, you're not. Shiva goes behind Sundaramurthy, oh, please sing about me, please, I'll do this to you. He gives you gold. One place he says, I'm not going to sing about you. Why? Because I don't have money. Okay, I'll give you gold. You are giving me gold, that's all fine. But if I travel there with the gold, what will I do? I want to go to Tiruvarur. By then he was staying in some other place. He said, you give me gold here, I have a problem. So don't worry, I will appoint my son, Vinayaka, to put all the gold to him into the tank and go and fetch it in Kamalalayam in Tiruvarur. So they goes and he's there, he sings one padigam, he gets back all the gold. These are all stories of Sundaramurthy Nayanar's association with Shiva. The matter goes here is that Sundaramurthy Nayanar chooses to fall in love with a dancer. Paravinachyar in Tiruvarur, Tiruvarur dancer. Now she's very scared that Sundaramurthy is going to come. Because she's a nangai, she's a Paravinachyar, she's a dancer. Now who's going to go to say the love? He says, you have to go, Shiva, no other choice. Shiva says, I would not, how will I go? Go somehow, but convince the matter, or else I will not sing. There's a poem like that. Actually, he says a poem. If you don't go, I will not sing on you. Shiva says, okay, I'll go. He goes as a Nayanar Adiyar. He goes as an Acharya. When the Paravai Nange sees Shiva, immediately shuts the door and said, oh, the Nayanar Adiyar have come to my house. I can't allow him inside. He says, oh God, it's an unsuccessful attempt. I can't do this. Shiva says, I don't know what to do, but you have to get the matter done. Next time he goes as Tyara Swami himself, with all the pani, with Vasuki and Ananta, he walks down the streets of Tiruvarur. By that, Nandi in Tiruvarur Tyara Swami Sannidhi actually stands with four legs because it never took him, like it never carried the lot this time. And with guilt, it's still standing. Because only in Sapta Vidanga and Prati Vidanga Stalams you find the standing Nandis in front of the bronzes. Standing Nandis, erect. and the ears very, very sharp, very close to the horns. Ear is not flat, which is flat is very happy. It's very vertical, it's very, very sharp looking at the Swami, so that, but the higher meaning is very different. The ears are there, Nandi is there. So just because Swami walked in Tiruvarur, that place, the space, his foot is landed, Tiruvarur becomes a very, very Punya Kshetram for walking to do Pradakshina. You would see the Thirumular says, let the world get the pleasure what I got. Yan Petra Inbam Perugai Vayagam. If I could say the secret of the cosmos, Vaan Patri Nindra Maraipurul Solidin, Oon Patri Nindra Unar Uru Mandiram, that particular mantra which is the secret behind holding the flesh and the bone and the manas and the atman together, if I could reveal to it, Oon Patri Nindra Unar Uru Mandiram, Tan Patra Patra Talai Padum Dane, it will go cross the head and descend down back. That place is called Mantra Simhasanam, where that particular 12 inch above head is where the Simhasanam, the Ratna Simhasanam where you see of the Arada Swami, is that Simhasanam 12 inches above the head, where the Shiva and Uma are seated, totally covered with flowers in the Pariyanka Yogam. Sri Tyagaraja Swami Idemi. Consort, she is called as Nilotpalambal, Kundi Katyayani Amman, as we say. According to the iconographists, they would say there is a constant look between Katyayani and Tyagaraja Swami. They always keep exchanging glances. So the bronze is not exactly in the center, little shifted and lifted, shifted together, this side. She is a, according to the Lakshanas of the women, someone can be called as Padmini. We know that. Shankini, Chitrini, Hattini. She is a Padmini. Uttama Jati. Naika. She is a Yogini, Kamalambal. Actually, Kamalambal is in the outer Prakaram. She is a Nitya Yogini. She gives her clan to serve Tyagaraja Swami. Such people are called as Kondi. Kondi Parambare. They are not called as Devadasis in Tiruvarur, they are called as Kondigal. Tiruvarur Kondigal. Kandagandu Kadalithu Kondi Ayinal. Trinavakarsa says. She sees and sees, the only job of a Kondi is to see Tyagaraja Swami and fall in love. To fall in love and constantly watching Tyagaraja Swami and falling in love. To watch. Akshi, Akshi, Akshi Sevana. For goddess, Akshi is very, very important. Especially, there is an Akshi cult even. Not very many people know about it. Kamakshi, Meenakshi, Visalakshi, Neelayadakshi and Kamalakshi, Panchakshi Devatas. Eyes of a goddess, Mukha Panchashati, hundreds shlokas are sung only on the eye of goddess, hundred shlokas. The eye in iconography of Indian goddesses is a separate chapter to be discussed. Eye is so important. She is the other half of the god. She is the yogini, she gives the power and there's an eye contact constantly. What is this Leela? It's Leela 361. It speaks about this in the Aradha Leela, Leela list. Actually, they dress like this. This is Kamalambal. The Kondis have been handed over to that. Red is their favorite color, and that white and red, they actually, we have changed it because they wear only white and with red blouses, whatever. They wear Shivakonda on the top. Lot of white flowers, only white, bhasma with kumkuma, with rudraksha, with lot of gold, but fully studded with rudraksha. They do a different kind of, altogether different kind of natana when Swami comes. They call kaigattu murai kaarigal. There are many terms given to them. This time we thought, if at all we know, they wear white, studded borders with gold, and a specific way to tie the kaccha. These have been little taught to us, so we could reproduce it for today's occasion. It's like the goddess seeking to, the entire Roopamu Joochi Valachi Vachitini has been kind of modeled across as if Sri Kamalambal is singing to, the Kondis are singing to Sri Tyara Swami today. The parrot is, though she is a yogini, she is also a bogini. This is actually, the best of the bogi is the best of the yogi. There is no second word about it. Out of all these things, one parrot makes all the difference, because she is still with that karma. She is not a dry soul who's given up everything, nothing. She's eternally in tapas, eternally in tapas. When Tyara Swami, I told you about the hand, when he comes out, when he comes by Vittavasam, that small entrance, he has to, when they take him out, they take a little turn here, because right there you find Kamalambal Sannidhi. He would little make, get the darshana of, that's called Kamalambal Darshana. Because Kamalambal has never crossed her barrier to get inside the second prakaram. She's always in the third prakaram. Yearly once he has to see Kamalambal. To get, yearly once, till she'll acquire all her tapas in the akshi of her. And when he comes, her akshi opens and gives the power, because she's a yogini. She's a bhattarika. She's a queen. She holds a katti here. She holds a sword here. She sits in a very specific asana called Kuttikasana. That's Kamalambal. That asana is called Kuttikasana. She has a sword there. She's the only goddess in Indian iconography who can have Chandra and Ganga. She also wears Ganga. She is more than Raja Rajeshwari in terms of Sri Vidya. When you go to the sanctum of Kamalambal, you have all the Yogeshwaris around. There is an Akshara Peetam there. There's a mantra pitam there, all the aksharas are written there. And believe me, people say great philosophical debates would happen only in front of the akshara pitam. Akshara is a very important episode in Indian philosophy. In connection with Professor Navjyoti, more or less he spent his entire span life investigating this word called akshara. Akshara pitam is there in Tiruvarur, and great debates, there are inscriptions to say great debates have happened in front of the akshara pitam. And Sri Kamalambal is a witness. She is a, people who know Lalita Sahasranam would know Vyakta Avyakta Swarupini. It's just written Vyakta Avyakta Swarupini as Kamalambal there. She is constantly in yoga, whatever we, I don't want to use the word meditation, but she is that. And she has given the entire clan of her service to Tyara Swami through Kondis. Kondi is that particular, the word Kondi in Tamil even today means one would never give up. A woman will never give up is called a Kondi. Hata. Anta hata. So that, such women are called Kondigal. Even in, now in Tamil, even a Kondi, they say. Like, because one who has that strength in her and conviction in her thought is called a Kondi, and they never budged. This conception about even the Kondis and the many temple service, women who did their service, offered their temple services. Kondis are women, most of them say, even to 5 feet of their life, they never had a man crossing. Leave alone anyone having them or whatever. There were women like this. And we need, see, the fading face of this particular matriarchal society, many things would have happened. But in their inception, people still remember about certain Kondis who are like doctors. They are healers. If some women never conceived, they would get as a dhana their sari one day and wear it and give it back. When Kondi finishes the service and walks back in the Tirumanjana Vidhi, they have quarters there. When they walked, people who could not see Tyaraja Swami, they would say, it is enough to see a Kondi. And that they actually, I've seen people saying that they would do Sashtanga Namaskaram when they walked. Not when they're walking. When they left, because they can't have contact with men, when they left, they would do namaskaram to the footprint on the sand. And they take the sand and they lock it into their, when something they goes, you want to do some work, to have the karya siddhi, they have the sand tied to their cloth, and still they say some of them have preserved the sand even today in the families of Tiruvarur. Some Kondis walked. They are healers. When someone never, they were never conceived, they never got married, children were sick, they were brought to Kondi's house. Kondis have a different kind of, it's a very different culture, it's a very different thought. They wear this and they dance in front of Tyagaraja Swami in a different sense. Let us see the hand.
Sri Tyagaraja Swami
exactly don't know how they dressed, but we only come to know through their parampara. The next hand is like a very interesting hand. When Durvasa Rishi did tapas in Tiruvarur, he asked the Lord to shower the Akasha Ganga and shower it in Tiruvarur. It fell on the earth and became a huge tank of 25 acres of Kamalalayam. The Akasha Ganga fell into the hairlock, descended down and became a big ocean, become a big, big tank.
Sri Tyagaraja Swami Sri
discussed, there's an Ajapa cult in the Tibetan and the northern part of the Trika school in Kashmir, Pratyabhigya school, you know. They're strongly influenced by the goddess cult. And there's a Shaiva Siddhanta school in the south. There's a marriage between both in Tiruvarur, because Tiruvarur has many, many matas. Pratyabhigya matas, the Trika school, and the Ajapa matas. To show that these philosophers were staying coexisting and discussing with each other in Tiruvarur, they symbolically do a marriage between Parvatavardhini Rajakumari with Shiva, South Indian man getting married. In the mid of the water pond of Kamalalayam, there's a small Naganatha Swami temple with Mangalambika. There's a Kalyanotsavam every during parts of the Brahmotsavam. And that happens, which the mountain goddess daughter, you got married. Oh Lord, what is this Leela? Alankara in Sanskrit, we know that. Like it's like saying, "Oh Rama, you're like equivalent to crore Ravanas." Mara koti sundara akara. Your body, your beauty is as equivalent to a koti manmata. To beautify each other, Abhasa Alankara is used in the charana. Mara koti sundara akara. It's not this is beautiful, face is beautiful, nothing. Someone knows the Angalakshana, if the shoulder, the arm flow, not even the shape, the flow of the arm is perfect, then the body would set. It's called Ajanubahu. If this is set, then you need not say anything about the body. If he is Ajanubahu, Rama, Sri Rama is called Ajanubahu. Just the word Ajanubahu will say what is the proportion of the entire body. You need not say this is beautiful, that is beautiful. No. Suggestion that beauty is here. Sundara Akara. It's not Sundara Akara. No. The composer, the subtlety of the composer is not Sundara, Sundara, Sundara. No. This. Which part can you show for a male and which for a female? If that is proper, the entire body is of Uttama Lakshana. The shoulder is Ajanubahu, extending as if it's going beyond the leg and touching the knee. They say, you know, the arms extend and touch the knee. That Prenkanam, just the last Prenkanam. That particular, yeah. That is as if it's extending and extending until the knees. Because there is no need to touch it. Dancing and touching, there's no need. Just suggestion that it's extending, like flowing like a river, but exactly stops. The hand does not go on and on and on. No, it stops. The measure also stops and says, Ajanubahu, he is a Sundara. Suggestion. The next hand, it's a very interesting hand, Ratna Simhasana of Sri Tyaraja Swami. The Simhasana is made of sandalwood. Covered filigree, worked with gold, studded with gems, with Ratna. It's called Ratna Simhasana, Mantra Peetam, Rahasya Peetam. It's called Veera Sodium. It's the entire Chola power works on the Simhasana itself, as if. Syara Swami is also called as Rajaraja, Rajaraja Maharaja, Anabaya Mahipala, Kulotunga. One who knows Chola history, you would say all these names are epithets of Chola kings. He himself Adi Chola, because they don't get it from him to God. From the God they get it. Interestingly, who is a Raja? That's another important episode one has to understand. That as I mentioned, the Dasha Anga. With this, someone enters to be a Maharaja. Actually, the Simhasanam is there. The sword is there. The umbrella for Tyara Swami. It's called the moon is the umbrella. He has a Veera, he has a pillai, a thunder. He has a scepter. All the epithets for him is has gone into the particular scepter given to Tyara Swami. He has a crown to hold. He has names, epithets to hold. Every normal man, till his antapura, he's a normal man. The moment he enters into the sadhas, he takes all the dashanga and becomes a Maharaja. This is called the Dasha Angas of the Maharaja. The Ratna Simhasanam is there, but it is studded with many other details around it. The Navagrahas, the sun and they don't have any power in Tiruvarur. Once they attacked by Asuras, they come and pray to Tyara Swami. Tyara Swami said, don't come and stay here, I'll take care of you. Only one condition, that you don't show your power here. I said, fine. They all stand in a straight line. Generally in South Indian temples, the Navagraha Peetam will be square in shape, but here it will be straight line, standing in a straight line. All of them worshipping in and around. Actually, in the main temple of Tiruvarur, where Tyara Swami is seated, instead of to have the icons of the Navagrahas, they light 9 lamps facing Tyara Swami. 9 lamps are lit to show that these are the 9 lamps which are lit here, so that side Tyara Swami is there and this side from here we are worshipping. So the Tyara Swami is there in the manas of the Prekshaka, the audience, and this is getting invoked. This is a monument. This is a monument. This is not a stone monument. Monuments are of different varieties. But this is a intangible monument. This is Tiruvarur. It's not just a location. This is Tiruvarur is getting created, architected and tectonified here by a work of art. So we are creating a monument here. Monuments are with food. Food create monument in Indic culture. Because when you eat something, they say, this is that place is Urka, this place is Pachadi. That the place is invoked. You can't take away the person. Monumentations are different varieties, and there's a specific way of monumentation. In fact, we would see the hasta for it. Oh. body radiates like sun. Dinakara Prabhai Pol Siranda Semmeni. Like radiant like a sun. Kanaka Vasanta Karpura Tyagar. Like a Dinakara Prabha, he radiates. Adishankara says, Shivaya Gauri Vadana Abja Brindam Suryaya. When Shiva, Gauri is like a lotus, like a Kamala, he becomes like a Surya, radiating like a sun. The sun like deep, like. Given in terms of Shiva, there is only one basma. Vibhuti, Basitam, Basmam, Saram, Raksha. There are five types actually. One which is made out of the dung, cow dung, when the cow is giving birth to a calf. There are many ways in which the cow dung is collected, many periods, many occasions. All the five is mixed in the Kanjatyaya Swami's protocol. In the evening, the Krishna Gandham, it's a very specific kind of a black paste, a perfume made. In the Mudaliya traditions, and Mudalis of Tiruvarur make that black paste. It's made out of 18 herbs with sandalwood, and it's a perfume, oil-based perfume. I think Hyderabad is one of the pivotal place for creation of indigenous perfumes, especially with oil base. Perfume is an art of royalty. He wears it in the two earlobes and in the center, and he goes for a walk. But that, when it's put mixed with the basma, it starts glittering. It starts glittering like when we get the basma, when we tap it off, it starts glittering. So like a sparkling basma he is wearing on the body, and he has a sundara akara through that. There's a talaichira, a golden ornament, and a golden yajnopavitam, studded with gems. He has a gold yajnopavitam, made out of gold. He wears a yajnopavitam, and he sits as a Rajaraja Maharaja, Anabaya Mahipala. We'll see that. Golden kinkinis. Maharajas wear golden kinkinis, not for dancing, but as veera, veera kinkini. Nataraja wears it in his scarf. There's a bell in the calf of Nataraja. It's called veeramani. Very equivalent to it, it's from the warrior tradition. Generally, warriors wear the bells in the ankles here. Kadavili tradition, and in certain warrior dance traditions, the bells are worn here. Here, he wears golden anklets, and he dances ajapa natana. The natanam he does is goes up and down, sides and sides he sways, like the body of Mahavishnu, where he's breathing up and down, he goes up and down. There's a Ratna Simhasanam around him, the hand is held like that to signify the Simhasana, up and down, and goes side by side as in terms of the ocean waves.
Ah
The entire work, what we saw today, is more about investigation of grammar. It's not about memorizing a hand after hand. They more or less give us a sense of an artful society of existence. The society as well was artful. It's not with art. Artful means that which has a sense of divinity to it. The word divinity is a little problematic in the modern sense, because actually divinity need not do anything to do with God. In the sense, in terms of gods, what we worship or something. There's something called a word called Sannitya. That is very interesting. That is what the urban mind is searching or doesn't have. There's a very famous quote by Nietzsche. He says that Christ is alive but God is dead. We are in such a phase that we can create many Christs now. With a flick of a finger, we can create a Christ. We can call for it. We can shout for it. We can stand by it. But can we create God? Is where, because such monuments, it's very interesting, a person like Rukmini Devi, the composer, need not visit Tiruvarur to create a work like this. Because when you know the grammar of it, how humanity has worked through it, because the work of art is never created on the material of it. The art is created in the mind of the onlooker. Art is not on the material there. What you look, the material there is not the art. Art is always here. Because at times a great painting can mean nothing to someone. A great work of art could mean nothing to someone. This entire work, the journey between the work of art and what is created, gets closer and closer because of the surroundings, because of the artful society. Yesteryears, this distance between the work of art and life was not very far. These information, what I say about Tiruvarur, not necessarily libraries gave me. You keep your feet in Tiruvarur, a cycle stand owner can give you some wisdom of Tiruvarur. But you could have not been 8th standard pass. The wisdom is a very, and this is not only to Tiruvarur, I know India, the entire spread of Eastern culture was like that. I had to say this, though I get reserved for my thank list. Many of the understandings, my initial understandings were from, I had to say this incident, that one of the Utsavam time when I entered Tiruvarur temple, I was leaving my shoes outside. There's a woman who used to string flowers in this temple outside. I have visited temple many times and she used to look after my shoes many times. When I came, she said, come, leave your shoes. And she was stringing. And something very peculiar happened. I said, I had to go to see the Swami. I said, okay, go take right. He's in the second prakaram. I said, how do you know? Like you're sitting here and stringing, the prakaram is inside. How do you know he's in the second prakaram? That came the reply. Ananda Bhairavi is singing, no? They are playing Ananda Bhairavi. I was shaken from my roots. I actually said, what? It is not musical geniosity. It's from the soil. This is what I'm saying. The distance between the work of art and the onlooker is very, very, it's blurred. You can't distinguish between one and the other. She is one of a teacher who slapped me on the face. She knows many musical details which others could not give me. It is not a musical detail to her, for her it's life. Because she is one of the hereditary people who are stringing flowers for Tyagaraswami, and she knows what to be worn, when, which flower, which kind, which music. Everything, because she's been seeing, she's been hearing the story, and the artful society around Tiruvarur is created by such lives. And this has nothing to do with bhakti, please let us not confuse with that. They stand for justice. Under the name of Tyagaraswami, justice is there. You can't shake it. It's deep-rooted justice and deep-rooted morality. More than anything, deep-rooted quest for beauty. This I have seen from every single person in that particular society. I have seen when they want to come to temple, immediately the best of what they can afford is worn and come to the temple. It's not just you wear a shabby thing. It has nothing to do with designing. It is nothing artificial. At least little they correct the kumkuma, little adjust their hair and enter. It is not bhakti, and I see that idea of beauty in it. I still remember one man said, when I'm going to see him, at least this much I should be a little beautiful, no? Because Tiruvarur has a very peculiar nomenclature. They say, when they see him, they never say, I went to see Swami, nothing. He's waiting there, no? He's waiting there. They talk like that. This is how they talk. And to witness that, they are very intact. And it's a very peculiar thing. We don't see that in the urban Tiruvarur even now. It's a sad thing. Sad, good, bad, that's a different comment. But the society that it can create, it can inspire a work like that. And it can create a monument here for us. A Tiruvarur was created right here. Is possible because of such artful society's existence and celebration of such choreographers and composers who can bring it out like this. To take Krishna anywhere, to take Sri, you know, Bhama anywhere, that walk, that one nadai, that walk what Bhama can do to establish where is she, what is she, these are edified memories and imagination of the people. They are not artistic creations. They are rock solid thoughts in the Indic culture. And such things are work of art, be it any other kshetram. I want to kind of wind up to say that we are in need of creation of artful societies and monumentations like this. Intangible monuments. There can be architectural monuments, yes. But they are, this is a monument. Through music, the Tiruvarur was created. Through Thalam, because there is a Ragaswarupam for Tiruvarur, there is a Thalaswarupam for Tiruvarur, there is a Natya Swarupam for Tiruvarur, not necessarily a temple Swarupam, not necessarily a Mandira Swarupam. There can be a dance Swarupam for Tiruvarur, Natya Swarupam for Tiruvarur. And this is Tiruvarur for us, and perhaps there is a study on it. Tiruvarur Sthalam, as interpreted by Srimati Rukmini Devi's choreography, perhaps the Sthalam which she never visited. Perhaps. Whole lot of people I wish to thank. Professor, the great guest, Kamisetti Garu, to who have graciously sat throughout the evening patiently and heard the discussion here. In his experience, who is a founder, who is a director for the Annamacharya project in TTT, I can perfectly empathize or kind of understand, because people like us, when we went to temples, what all problems we had, even to get the right knowledge. And people like them, they have been doing that throughout their lifetime. I know it's a thankless job. Because many a times we do about these temples, we know what it is and what this ought to be. Namaskaram, sir, for all the things, for your presence. Anuradha Garu, for offering this thinking cap's first work to me. Nattuvangam, Anupama Garu, sorry. Anupama Kylash, vocal support TK sisters, Saroja, Dr. Saroja and Sujatha, Shrimati Sujatha, Mridangam Sri R. Shrikanth, Violin Sri O. Rajashekar. I thank my dance teachers Meera Narayan and Gopinathan, Leela Samson, Professor C. Chandrasekhar, Bragaka, Sadhana Balakrishnan, who taught me Kathakali. They constantly encouraged me for this work. Now, whatever work I do, they've always been my support, but constantly correcting me, putting me into line, tightening me when I wanted. My parents, yes, essentially my father and mother and my wife, who have borne the entire life with me, bearing all my idiosyncrasies. My friends and colleagues from my college days who have always been my support, even if they don't interfere in my matter, they've always been my support. My colleagues in IIIT, every single day we had a whole lot of discussion with Sunil or Saroja Garu or Pranav there and Rajesh or everyone around who, every single day debates, Shajid here and who's behind the camera here, and philosophy, dance, music, theatre, painting, where it starts, where it ends, nothing. And finally, one day we identified we're all speaking the same problem. We have a common humanity problem to address. Actually, a great scholar who inspired me here in Hyderabad to work more, who graciously accepted to be this evening, is Dr. Chudamani Garu. I think she's here. She has been a pivotal person of interest to me, and She is the mother of Dr. Saroja and Sujatha. But she herself a great Vaishnava scholar and lot of interactions and education with her. The first person who made Tiruvarur the word familiar to me was a Dutch woman, Saskia Kesseboom. Her book introduced me to the word Tiruvarur as it is supposed to be. And Dr. Chitra Madhavan, her temple lectures, Professor Raghuraman in Madras, who has inspired me and treated me like a friend in his career. My Kalakshetra colleagues and friends who have constantly inspired me to work. More than anyone, my Kalakshetra students who have constantly bothered with my questions to work. especially my friend Sibi Sudarshan, I wish to recollect because he has worked with me for many years on this demonstration part. I would do the lecture for many years. And my friends Lokesh, Rakesh, many of them who helped me. When it comes to Tiruvarur, my first inquiry is about an advocate, Vidhi Vidangan, who made me work this. The Nadaswara Vidwans, Selva Ganapati, his sons Karnanidhi, Padani, because I had to mention these words, because I'm no one in term without them. I'm saying Adiyarkan Allan, who's no more, he's a great scholar, I think India had lost him. He wrote only one book of 60 pages to 80 pages, I believe, that is like a sutra. It's very difficult to understand what he has written. Dandapani sir, who's a hereditary service holder to Tiruvarur temple. The garland, the women who strung the garland, the women who fed me payasam, the cycle stand owners, many, many great scholars of Tiruvarur. Essentially, the last Kondi, Padmashri Ramathilakamma, who taught me many things and who shared many things of Tiruvarur to me. Tiruvaraputur, Jeevaratnamala and Kasturi, my teachers from Kumbakonam. And last but not the least, before coming to Hyderabad, I was locked within these information details of Tiruvarur. But when I came and stepped into Hyderabad, I am in debt to Professor Navjyoti, who relieved me from Tiruvarur, actually. Because he relieved me from the clutches of Tiruvarur. He relieved me from the clutches of Srirangam. He relieved me from the clutches of Chidambaram. And he made me understand what Tiruvarur-ness is. He made me understand what Chidambaram-ness is and what is the ness of humanity. Information is fine. He would say, information is fine. Your memory is there. Good. I understand, boy, your information is good. Your memory is fine. It's all fine. But do you know scholarship is not about information? Now, the information technology world has brought the entire world's information into your palm top. So what do you do with information anymore? Information is nothing. It's in your palm now. How do you interpret information as scholarship? It's not information gathering garbage. How do you work with it? One line is enough. One line of information is enough. But what do you work with is scholarship and normal information memory. We all, as people from Center for Exact Humanities, IIIT, graciously or with all the dedication, it's not just an obituary, they would say, that a man who made us realize what the ness of art is. And at least he relieved us from the clutches, but we have been bound with rules, whatever say as art. And later he made us very clearly understand that whatever our teachers taught is pedagogy, it is not art. And when we went back and verified with the teacher, they said, yeah, we only taught you, this is not art. What you create out of it is art. You go back and work to the world, talk to the world and come back to us. Don't come back very often and keep talking. Go, meet the ocean, meet the storm there out. You're not made out of salt and sugar. Go and fight it out and come back. And they gave us a sword of wisdom to work with. And with this ness, the sense of Tiruvarur-ness, these great walking stalwarts are implanted, ingrained to us. I would say, with great humility to another artist, co-artist who stood here, with all the patience she bore with me and she has been working with me. She also comes from the alma mater, and she knows what I speak when I speak about Roopamu Joochi. With both of us, on behalf of both of us, we say a namaskaram to all of you all who have spent the evening. Thank you.
Well, I don't think I should say much after that. I'll just say one thing. What a beginning to thinking cap. That's all I'll say. But before I honor the artist for this evening, I must ask Master Garu, Kamshetty Srinivasan Garu, to say a few words about what he feels about this whole thing we have undertaken and about Tiruvarur Sthalam and its presentation today.
Mm-hmm.